Regular walkers or cyclists along Burrows Walk and then to Garrett Hostel Lane will probably have noticed that the signs leading up to the crossing on either side have been refreshed. Now, that I welcome, but I am utterly bewildered why anybody would think that painting cycling and walking signs on Garrett Hostel Lane itself is useful. I have never, in all the time I have cycled and actually walked there, had a problem with anybody, and I haven't noticed anybody else having a problem with anybody either. And I'm wondering particularly what consultations took place.
Has anybody got any of the answer? No? Thank you, Beth, for the question. And it's good to be able to discuss this at the Western Central Area Committee because it's been discussed a fair amount online by the cycle campaign. The new painting on Garrett Hostel Bridge is there as a result of a local highways bid that I put in last year. That went through the standard local highways process. It was examined in front of the panel last spring and then was taken through by county council officers and discussed with the city council conservation team over the summer. I'm quite surprised to hear you say that you've never had a problem cycling or walking in that area, because I cycle and walk through there very, very frequently, and there are frequent, not collisions, although there are collisions, but frequent near misses between cyclists and pedestrians on that route. And the idea of putting those signs in was just to make it clear that this is a shared use path, and that the purpose behind it was to try and get to something like what we have on Lammersland, which is a division, so that when cyclists and pedestrians use that path across Lammersland, both kinds of people use both sides, but they know which, if there's to be a conflict, each type of use knows which way to move. And that doesn't happen on Garrett Hostel Bridge. When you are coming along Garrett Hostel Lane and on that piece of path, there are frequently people standing in the middle not knowing which way to go as they are approached by a bike. And so that was the purpose of the signs. And I'm sorry if people don't like them, but they are relatively light touch. They're not actually instructing anybody to do anything, and I hope that they will reduce the conflict. But they did go through absolutely the standard procedure for local highway improvement schemes.
Can I ask, Rich, do you want to comment on this question? Because it's one of your questions as well.
Yeah, thank you. So I too was concerned about this. I think there's only signage on one side of the bridge, so I don't think it's going to affect the other. So is this a completed project, or is there more of it to come? And if this was a local highways improvement scheme, who was the sponsor who put the 10% of the money forward? Was it one of those schemes which had to have some money put forward by someone else? And is there going to be any monitoring of its either effectiveness or any impact that it has?
It is a partly completed scheme. There is a plan to put a similar indication on the far side of the bridge, but the reason that hasn't been done is that as a result of the exploration that I did with the County Council officers, they recognised that the surface on the other side of the bridge was thoroughly overdue for resurfacing. So that side of the bridge is due to be the surface of it is will be redone because it's entirely full of potholes, and after that has happened, similar markings will be put on the other side of the bridge. But again, only one, similar to the ones that have been put on. So it is a part completed project. In terms of monitoring, first of all, you asked about the match funding. The match funding for local highways bids in the city comes from a fund from the City Council, and City Councillors sit on the panel in order to make the decisions about the bids, and once those decisions have been passed, the match funding happens automatically. So that's where the match funding will have come from. And the final question was about monitoring. I think it would be extremely difficult to monitor the success or failure of this project for a variety of reasons, one of which is that I anticipate that although the use of that bridge is already very high, there are already a very large number of cyclists and walkers who use that area.
given the expansion that's happening on west to the west of the city and in the north, on the northwest side, I would anticipate that there will be an increasing number and a consistently increasing number of people using that route. So it would be very difficult to make any kind of monitoring given the increase in the number of people using it.
Thank you.